Hello everyone, welcome back. Today I'm back with a very tasty and quick style of preparing chicken masala. So let's get started. At first, I'll prepare a green chutney out of 1 inch of ginger, 15 garlic cloves, around 5 to 6 green chili based on the spiciness level you like to eat, and 1 handful of coriander leaves. So grind it to a chutney consistency and keep it aside. Along with that, I've taken 1 tomato pureed and 1 onion sliced small. So prepare all this and keep it aside. Now to a hot kadai, I'll be adding 1 tablespoon of ghee and 2 tablespoons of cooking oil. You can use any cooking oil. To this, once it gets heated up, I'll add 1/2 teaspoon of jeera seeds. And to this, I'll add few other garam masalas, that is 1 bay leaf, 1 star and 3 cloves. Fry it well. After frying it for few seconds, I'll add the washed chicken. I have around 500 grams of chicken. So I'll add it directly to the tadka and fry it well. For around 7 to 8 minutes, I'll fry it well. Ensure you keep the flame really high in order to avoid the chicken from releasing extra water. So keep frying it well for around 7 to 8 minutes. So after 7 to 8 minutes, I'll add the green chutney what we have prepared earlier out of garlic, ginger, coriander leaves and green chili. I'll cover it with a lid and allow it to steam for 5 minutes. Ensure the flame is now on medium flame. After 5 minutes, I'll add the chopped onions and give it a good mix. After around 2 minutes, I'll add few other masalas, that is 1 teaspoon of Kashmiri chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of jeera powder, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder and 1/2 teaspoon of coriander powder. At the same time, I'll add the tomato puree. I have around 1 large tomato puree here. At the same time, I'll add salt. You can add salt as required. Give it a good mix. And now let the masala get cooked well with the chicken. Cover it with the lid and allow it to steam for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, I'll add 2 tablespoons of yogurt, which I've whisked it really well. So whisk it well before you add it to the masala. Give it a good mix and allow the chicken to get cooked for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, for garnishing, I'll be adding 1/2 teaspoon of crushed pepper, 2 tablespoons of kasturi methi, and 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala. Give it a good mix and at the end allow it to steam for 2 minutes on a medium flame. And then the chicken masala is all ready to be served. You can see the oil released on top, which clearly indicates that the masala and the chicken has been perfectly cooked and is all ready to be served hot. This chicken masala goes well with everything. Dosa, naan, kulcha or even with rice. Do try and let me know your review on the same. Thank you for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.